Definitely, you know, whenever Obadongo gets ninth place because he has to lose to a top five player, and Scizor gets ninth place because he loses to like a top 30 player. You
yeah,
know?
Yeah.
But
definitely
here we go.
There.
We're starting off game one.
All right. So okay. We're going to Lylat.
Okay, this is definitely a Rob advantage stage for in this matchup. Lylat's really good for Rob because Gyro on Lylat's actually has the dumbest things. Gyro on Tilt, you can actually grab and then keep pummeling, and Gyro will constantly hit the pummel
wow.
grab person.
That sounds
and it
dirty.
Can do like 70%.
Yeah, it also feels like Rob doesn't get hurt by the stage like most projectile campers do, because he can like angle his lasers. Gyro bounces up and down the stage. It doesn't really get stopped like something like Falco's lasers. Right?
Yeah, really. And then, you know, a Gyro on Lylat's Tilt has a lot of utility compared to, you know, a Gyro on Smashville, because you throw the Gyro on the tilted Lylat and it bounces and it moves as it bounces.
Exactly.
So you can do some really cool tricks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it definitely seems like it's probably a fun stage for Rob to play on. But this is looking pretty close to even. J-Swiss has a little bit of the lead.
Yeah, but Link does have more. Oh,
wow.
I was going to say more kill power, but there's the up smash right there looking real good.
That was a. Yeah. That, I mean, I guess it was safe for him to go for that because Bob Ross was not in the position to punish him and he missed, but I'm surprised that hit.
All right, just playing the safe camp game. I mean, that's what you do as Rob. And the thing about Rob, which is fun, is that when you camp with him, it doesn't really feel too much like camping. Because, you know, because you got Gyro, you got Nair. Like,
right.
You're doing a lot of stuff. You're mm-hmm. not running away, per se. You're just walling out.
Right, exactly.
And you're not really being repetitive either, mm-hmm. which is, you know, what you do with, like, Bay or Cloud. Just back air.
Yeah. Oh. He has ways of mixing up his camping, but Bob Ross in that dash attack gonna secure a first kill for him.
Oh, very strong forward air, calling out the Nair. Nair, I believe, has, I think it's like 21 frames of startup.
Yeah, it seems like Bob Ross isn't having too much trouble with Nair in this matchup right now. Wow, okay, and that's gonna be another up smash.
I was about to say, too much problem, but up smash. Really
yeah.
Looking like J-Swiss is having a good time with that one.
Yeah, both stocks, of Bob Ross going down due to up smash, and I feel like those are some really intelligent up smash placements by J-Swiss. Neither time that it happened did I... Okay, maybe the last one. I was going to say neither time did I expect that, oh, up smash is coming out.
Yeah.
But that last one, he was getting up from the ledge, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I just pulled it up. Nair is frame 18, so...
Wow.
So yeah, you can definitely... Definitely react to that,
yeah.
which is good if you're Link, because you can throw that up air out, which is what Bob Ross needs to be doing. Because
okay, you think up air would be a good option?
Oh, I think any option that
Nair?
Is
Nair for
that,
sure.
that can hit, you know, I think Bob Ross can definitely challenge Nair. He just needs to use the right moves, maybe even just up smash, honestly, because Rob needs Nair to land. Oh God, but
yeah, he is
he
really barraging
to,
him off.
I was about
right
to
now.
Say he doesn't even need to land right now because he's the one doing all the juggling.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Bob Ross looking like he's trying to give himself some space right now, more time to think. Smart recovery by Bob Ross. Great. J-Swiss not
throw,
holding up.
Up air. Deep boop.
Probably waits out the air dodge, and that is a zero to death.
Yeah.
J-Swiss has not taken any damage yet.
Bob Ross definitely feeling a little flustered here.
Yeah, he's going to have to make quite the comeback.
Oh, the gyro cancels out the boomerang. This JV3 is still alive.
J-Swiss playing extremely immaculate right
oh,
now.
Oh, and as we said that, Bob Ross definitely getting back in here.
Oh. Yeah, he's just dancing around Bob Ross right now.
Yeah, all these... Oh, there we go. Grab back air. Oh, up tilt. Okay.
Okay. Racking up some good hits. Commits really hard to the edge guard.
Smart
okay.
reverse up B.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
The
I was
problem,
that,
though, is that if he gets down air, you know, he's dead.
Yeah.
He's so dead.
I was worried that he was going to have to
yeah,
give
see?
Up a lot
there we
of
go.
Stage.
Up here to catch the Nair. That's what Link needs to do, because Rob's Nair is slow.
Especially, I feel like being under Rob is a very good place for any character to be, because Rob can't really do much to you when you're below him, except for, like, fast fall Nair or something like that.
Yeah, pretty much.
His down air comes out way too slow.
Yeah, his down air is actually slower than his Nair, coming out of frame 20.
Yeah.
And also, it stalls him in the air. It only has six active hitboxes, or seven active hitboxes and frames of hitbox, instead of the... Oh, God. That's 14. So Nair's got 14, you know, double the active frames.
Yeah, it's one of the things... Oh, up air would have been a better option
oh,
there, but down air is going
landing
to steal
down
a kill
air,
for him.
That is scrub tactics right there.
And just like that, this is not looking too bad for
no,
Bob
it is,
Ross.
Because dead.
Oh, you
yeah,
called it. You called
yeah,
it. Yeah, as soon as he ended up on the edge.
Yeah, he held the ledge too long, and that was just... Can't mm-hmm. do that. You really
yeah.
can.
Yeah, which is, it's hard not to do that against Rob, who's sort of setting up a playground of his own
yeah,
when
exactly.
you're on the edge. So that's going to be 2-0 going over to J-Swiss.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it started to look like Bob Ross was going to be able to mount a really good comeback right there. But the moment he...